Recording?
Yeah.
She's on.
The Toltec Path to Freedom. Breaking old agreements. Ever hold the initiation of the dead? The initiation of the dead is found in many traditions and esoteric schools around the world. We find it in Egypt, India, Greece, and America. This is a symbolic death which kills the parasite without harming our physical body. When we die symbolically, the parasite has to die. This is faster than the first two solutions, but it is even more difficult to do. We need a great deal of courage to face the angel of death. We need to be very strong. Let's take a closer look at each of these solutions. The art of transformation, the dream of the second attention. We've learned that the dream you're living now is the result of the outside dream, poking your attention and feeding you all of your beliefs. The process of domestication can be called the dream of the first attention, because it was how your attention was used for the first time to create the first dream of your life. One way to change your beliefs is to focus your attention on all those agreements and beliefs and change the agreements yourself. In doing this, you're using your attention for the second time, thus creating the dream of the second attention, or the new dream. The difference is that you're no longer innocent. When you were a child, this was not true. You didn't have a choice.
I'm setting up right now. I'm going to give myself some money.
But you're no longer a child. Now it's up to you to choose what to believe and what not to believe. You can choose to believe in anything, and that includes believing in yourself. The first step is to become aware of the fog that is in your mind. You must become aware that you are dreaming all the time. Only with awareness do you have the possibility of transforming your dream. If you have the awareness that the whole drama of your life is the result of what you believe, and what you believe is not real, then you can begin to change it. However, to really change your beliefs, you need to focus your attention on what it is that you want to change. The decision to adopt the four agreements is a declaration of war to regain your freedom from the parasite. The four agreements offer the possibility of ending the emotional pain, which can open the door for you to enjoy your life and begin a new dream. It's up to you to explore the possibilities of your dream if you're interested. The four agreements were created to assist you in the art of transformation, to help you break the limiting beliefs, gain more personal power, and become stronger. The stronger you get, the more agreements you can break, until the moment comes when you make it to the core of all those agreements. Going to the core of those agreements is what I call going into the desert. When you go into the desert, you meet your demons face to face. After coming out of the desert, all those demons become angels. Practicing the four new agreements is a big act of power. Breaking the spell of black magic in your mind requires great personal power. Every time you break an agreement, you gain extra power. You start by breaking agreements that are very small and require less power. As those smaller agreements are broken, your personal power will increase until you reach a point when you can finally face the big demons in your mind. For example, the little girl who was told not to sing is now 20 years old, and she still does not sing. One way she can overcome the belief that her voice is ugly is to say, "Okay, I will try to sing even if I do sing badly." Then she can pretend that someone is clapping and telling her, "Oh, that was beautiful." This may break the agreement a teeny tiny bit, but it will still be there. However, now she has a little more power and courage to try again and again until finally she breaks the agreement. That's one way out of the dream of hell. But for every agreement you break that makes you suffer, you'll need to replace it with a new agreement that makes you happy. This will keep the old agreement from coming back. If you occupy the same space with a new agreement, then the old agreement is gone forever. And in its place is the new agreement. There are many strong beliefs in the mind that can make this process look hopeless. That's why you need to go step by step and be patient with yourself, because this is a slow process. The way you're living now is the result of many years of domestication. You cannot expect to break the domestication in one day. Breaking agreements is very difficult because we put the power of the word, which is the power of our will, into every agreement we have made. We need the same amount of power to change an agreement. We cannot change an agreement with less power than we use to made the agreement, and almost all our personal power is invested in keeping the agreements we have with ourselves. That's because our agreements are actually like a strong addiction. We are addicted to being the way we are. We are addicted to anger, jealousy, and self-pity. We are addicted to the beliefs that tell us, I'm not good enough, I am not intelligent enough, why even try? Other people will do it because they're better than me. All of these old agreements, which rule our dream life, are the result of repeating them over and over. Therefore, to adopt the four agreements, you need to put repetition in action. Practicing the new agreements in your life. The discipline of the warrior, controlling your own behavior. Imagine that you awake early one morning, overflowing with enthusiasm for the day. You feel good, you're happy, and have plenty of energy to face the day. Then at breakfast, you have a big fight with your spouse, and a flood of emotion comes out. You get mad, and in the emotion of anger, you spend a lot of personal power. After the fight, you feel drained, and you just want to go and cry. In fact, you feel so tired that you go to your room, collapse, and try to recover. You spend the day wrapped up in your emotions. You have no energy to keep going, and you just want to walk away from everything. Every day we awake with a certain amount of mental, emotional, and physical energy that we spend throughout the day. If we allow our emotions to deplete our energy, we have no energy to change our life or to give to others. The way you see the world will depend upon the emotions you're feeling. When you're angry, everything around you is wrong. Nothing is right. You blame everything, including the weather. Whether it's raining, the sun is shining, nothing pleases you. When you're sad, everything around you is sad and makes you cry. You see the trees and you feel sad. You see the rain and everything looks so sad. Perhaps you feel vulnerable and have a need to protect yourself because you don't know in what moment someone will attack you. You do not trust anything or anyone around you. This is because you see the world with the eyes of fear. Imagine that the human mind is the same as your skin. You can touch healthy skin and it feels wonderful. Your skin is made for perception, and the sensation of touch is wonderful. Now imagine you have an injury and the skin gets cut and infected. If you touch the infected skin, it's going to hurt. So you try to cover and protect the skin. You will not enjoy being touched because it hurts. Keep living in the dream of the planet. The second choice is to do what we do as children when parents try to domesticate us. We can rebel and say no. We can declare a war against the parasite, a war against the judge and the victim, a war for our independence, a war for the right to use our own mind and our own brain. That is why in all the shamanic traditions in America, from Canada to Argentina, people call themselves warriors, because they are in a war against the parasite in the mind. That is the real meaning of a warrior. The warrior is one who rebels against the invasion of the parasite and declares a war. But to be a warrior doesn't mean we always win a war. We may win, we may lose, but we always do our best, and at least we have a chance to be free again. Choosing this path gives us, at the very least, the dignity of rebellion, and ensures that we will not be the helpless victim of our own whimsical emotions or the poisonous emotions of others. Even if we succumb to the enemy, the parasite, we will not be among those victims who would not fight back. At best, being a warrior gives us an opportunity to transcend the dream of the planet and to change our personal dream to a dream that we call heaven. Just like hell, heaven is a place that exists within our mind. It is a place of joy, a place where we are happy, where we are free to love and to be who we really are. We can reach heaven while we're alive. We don't have to wait till we die. God is always present, and the kingdom of heaven is everywhere. But first, we need to have the eyes and ears to see and hear that truth. We need to be free of the parasite. The parasite can be compared to a monster with 1,000 heads. Every head of the parasite is one of the fears that we have. If we want to be free, we have to destroy the parasite. One solution is to attack the parasite head by head, which means we face each of our fears one by one. This is a slow process, but it works. Every time we face one of the fears, we are a little more free. The second approach is to stop feeding the parasite. If we don't give the parasite any food, we kill the parasite by starvation. To do this, we have to gain control of our emotions. We have to refrain from fueling the emotions that come from fear. This is easy to say, but it is very difficult to do. It is difficult because the judge and the victim control our mind. A third solution is called the initiation of the dead. The initiation of the dead is found in many traditions and esoteric schools around the world. We find it in Egypt, India, Greece, and America. This is a symbol. symbolic death, which kills the parasite without harming our physical body. When we die symbolically, the parasite has to die. This is faster than the first two solutions, but it is even more difficult to do. We need a great deal of courage to face the angel of death. We need to be very strong. Let's take a closer look at each of these solutions. The art of transformation, the dream of the second attention. We've learned that the dream you're living now is the result of the outside dream, poking your attention and feeding you all of your beliefs. The process of domestication can be called the dream of the first attention, because it was how your attention was used for the first time to create the first dream of your life. One way to change your beliefs is to focus your attention on all those agreements and beliefs and change the agreements with yourself. In doing this, you're using your attention for the second time, thus creating the dream of the second attention with a new dream. The difference is that you're no longer innocent. When you were a child, this was not true. You didn't have a choice. But you're no longer a child. Now it's up to you to choose what to believe and what not to believe. You can choose to believe in anything. And that includes believing in yourself. The first step is to become aware of the fog that is in your mind. You must become aware that you are dreaming all the time. Only with awareness do you have the possibility of transforming your dream. If you have the awareness that the whole drama of your life is the result of what you believe, and what you believe is not real, then you can begin to change it. However, to really change your beliefs, you need to focus your attention on what it is that you want to change. You have to know which agreements you want to change before you can change them. So the next step is to develop awareness of all the self-limiting, fear-based beliefs that make you unhappy. You take an inventory of all that you believe, all your agreements, and through this process, you begin the transformation. The Toltecs called this the art of transformation, and it's a whole mastery. You achieve the mastery of transformation by changing the fear-based agreements that make you suffer and reprogramming your own mind in your own way. One of the ways to do this is to explore and adopt alternative beliefs, such as the four agreements. The decision to adopt the four agreements is a declaration of war to regain your freedom from the parasite. The four agreements offer the possibility of ending the emotional pain, which can open the door for you to enjoy your life and begin a new dream. It's up to you to explore the possibilities of your dream if you're interested. The four agreements were created to assist you in the art of transformation, to help you break the limiting agreements, gain more personal power, and become stronger. The stronger you get, the more agreements you can break, until the moment comes when you make it to the core of all those agreements. Going to the core of those agreements is what I call going into the desert. When you go into the desert, you meet your demons face to face. After coming out of the desert, all those demons become angels. Practicing the four new agreements is a big act of power. Breaking the spell of black magic in your mind requires great personal power. Every time you break an agreement, you gain extra power. You start by breaking agreements that are very small and require less power. As those smaller agreements are broken, your personal power will increase until you reach a point when you can finally face the big demons in your mind. For example, the little girl who was told not to sing is now 20 years old, and she still does not sing. One way she can overcome the belief that her voice is ugly is to say, "Okay, I will try to sing even if I do sing badly." Then she can pretend that someone is clapping and telling her, "Oh, that was beautiful." This may break the agreement a teeny, tiny bit, but it will still be there. However, now she has a little more power and courage to try again and again, until finally she breaks the agreement. That's one way out of the dream of hell. But for every agreement you break that makes you suffer, you need to replace it with a new agreement that makes you happy. This will keep the old agreement from coming back. If you occupy the same space with a new agreement, then the old agreement is gone forever, and in its place is the new agreement. There are many strong beliefs in the mind that can make this process look hopeless. That's why you need to go step by step and be patient with yourself, because this is a slow process. The way you are living now is the result of many years of domestication. You cannot expect to break domestication in one day. Breaking agreements is very difficult, because we put the power of the word, which is the power of our will, into every agreement we have made. We need the same amount of power to change an agreement. We cannot change an agreement with less power than we use to make the agreement, and almost all our personal power is invested in keeping the agreements we have with ourselves. That's because our agreements are actually like a strong addiction. We are addicted to being the way we are. We are addicted to anger, jealousy, and self-pity. We are addicted to the beliefs that tell old agreements which rule our dream of life are the result of repeating them over and over. Therefore, to adopt the four agreements, you need to put repetition in action.
Of course, we would hardly
never like each other because it will be too painful. So it would need to create a lot of distance between us. The human eye is exactly used to reflect the skin. Every human has an emotional body completely covered with infected wounds. Each wound is infected with emotional poison. The poison of all the emotions that makes us suffer, such as hate, anger, envy, and sadness. An action of injustice opens a wound in the mind, and we react with emotional poison because of the concepts and beliefs we have about injustice and what is fair. The mind is so wounded and full of poison by the process of domestication that everyone describes the wounded mind as normal. This is considered normal, but I can tell you, it is not normal. We have a dysfunctional dream of the planet. Humans are mentally sick with a disease called fear. The symptoms of the disease are all the emotions that make humans suffer. Anger, hate, sadness, envy, and betrayal. When the fear is too great, the reasoning mind begins to fail and become this mental illness. Psychotic behavior occurs when the mind is so frightened and the wound so painful that it seems better to break contact with the outside world. If we can see our state of mind as a disease, there is a cure. We don't have to suffer any longer. First, we need the truth to open the emotional wounds, take the poison out, and heal the wounds completely. How do we do this? We must forgive those we feel have wronged us. Not because they deserve to be forgiven, but because we love ourselves so much, we don't want to keep paying for the injustice. Forgiveness is the only way to heal. We can choose to forgive because we feel compassion for ourselves. We can let go of the resentment.